वेलकम टू श्रीमती एलपी सवानी विद्याभवन सोशल साइंस स्टैंडर्ड 10th चैप्टर 11 इंडिया वाटर रिसोर्सेस। वाटर इज लाइफ, इफ देर इज वाटर हैंस देर इज लाइफ। एनी टाइप ऑफ लाइफ कैन नॉट बी इमेजिन्ड ऑन अर्थ विदाउट वाटर। देर इज नो अदर ऑप्शन ऑफ वाटर। दस वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड वाटर इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिसोर्स। द लिस्ट of usages of water is very long. Entire biotic world uses water to sustain itself. The prosperity of any nation depends on its agriculture and the amount of water it uses in it. Water is also required for all the domestic purposes, also in industries and many other reasons. Water shortage. This is being created because of rate of volume at which the water is being used by increasing population and for development projects. With this consideration, it is very much necessary to use water sparingly. That means we should use water sparingly, means only reasonable use of water should be there. Water is a limited resource and so it should be used sparingly. It is an inseparable part of our life. So there are three sources of water. First is rain water, surface water, ground water. Three sources of water. The first one is rain water. Rain is the original source of water. Rivers, lakes, streams, well, etc. are secondary sources. They get filled only when the rainfall is there. So they are the secondary sources of water. All these sources are due to rainfall. Number two, surface water. The water on the surface of the earth is found in the form of river, lake, pond, streams, etc. And this is called as surface water. The third source of water that we have is the groundwater. Groundwater has an important place among the sources of water. It is obtained due to the process of water absorbed by the lower strata of the land. How is groundwater collected? When rainfall occurs, right, there is the water reaches, penetrates right to the lower strata of the land, and then it gets accumulated over there. So in this way, the groundwater level is formed, and slowly, gradually, with increase in rain, there can be increase in the water table also. In northern India, there is 42% of groundwater. In southern India, there is less of groundwater due to plateau and mountainous region. Here you can understand, you can see that 42% of groundwater we can find in the northern part, whereas in the southern part there is less groundwater because of the mountainous regions. Groundwater is utilized maximum for irrigation, right? What is the major use of groundwater? So that is, we use it for irrigation. Next topic is water resources and uses. The first uses of water that we are going to see here is irrigation, water used for irrigation. About 84% of water in India is useful for irrigation. For example, about if we want to grow 1 kg of wheat, it requires 1500 liters of water. So you can understand what will be the need of water to grow certain crops like paddy, sugarcane, which require more water, right? Wheat is a crop which requires not much water. Then also 1500 liters of water, if we have, we can grow 1 kg of wheat. It helps in growing 1 kg of wheat. Same way, depending on the type of the crops, the requirement of water will differ. So water is being used for irrigation since ancient times, right? In the 2nd century, the famous canal Grand Aniket, it was constructed across the river Kaveri, and then in 1882, the Eastern Yamuna Canal was also constructed in Uttar Pradesh. There are three mediums of irrigations in India. Okay, they are wells and tube wells, canals and ponds. These are the three main mediums of irrigation. means water, these are the three places from where we the Indian people, farmers, take water for irrigation. Out of these, wells and canals are major mediums of irrigation. Canals and ponds, they come on the second and on the third place, second on and third place respectively. Canal irrigation is practiced in vast plains of Satluj, Ganga and Yamuna, and also in the delta regions of Mahanadi, Godavari, Krishna and Kaveri in the eastern plains. Wells and tube wells are very common in the alluvial plains, and irrigation by ponds is practiced in eastern and southern states. This is how different ways of irrigation are practiced in different places. Water resources, the second use that we are going to see here is multi-purpose projects. Many large and small rivers are flowing in India, right? Water transportation is rich in India because of these rivers. This is because of the physiography. It is in such a way that many rivers merge with each other and empty the water into the sea. With the idea that this water may be harnessed. Harnessed means can be utilized or saved, something like that. Okay, so it can be harnessed for various purposes. Multi-purpose projects are planned on many rivers with an intention that instead of getting the water wasted, we should save this water, we should harness this water and make it make a proper use of it. And with this purpose, multi-purpose project has been planned on many rivers. A multi-purpose project means to solve various problems. That is the reason it is named as multi-purpose project. It solves many problems. For example, when a dam has been constructed on a river, it includes that it will solve the different problems like flood control, prevention of soil erosion, water for drinking and irrigation will be available, water will be available for the industries also, water will be can be provided to settlements, that is human settlements, generation of electricity can be possible, what we call it as hydroelectricity. Internal water transportation can be started, whereas entertainment areas are also can be developed nearby, from which a lot of people can get employment. Wildlife protection and development of fisheries, etc. These kinds of work purpose can be served by making a multi-purpose project. Distribution of area under irrigation. There is a difference regarding the area under irrigation in every state. Area under irrigation, this term we need to understand first. Distribution of area under irrigation means in different places, how much area is been irrigated, okay, where these facilities of irrigation are available or are being used. We are talking about that when we say area under irrigation. So there is a difference regarding the area under irrigation in every state. Coastal districts in Andhra Pradesh, delta regions of Godavari and Krishna rivers, Mahanadi Delta in Orissa, Kaveri Delta in Tamil Nadu, Punjab, Haryana and Western Uttar Pradesh, etc. These are the regions of intensive irrigation of the country. Means maximum irrigation, use of these irrigation facilities are being found, utilized in these parts of the country. After independence, the irrigated area in India has increased 4 times. The irrigation is practiced in about 38% of net sown area. Net sown area, okay, I'm talking about. Means the total area sown in the whole country. There is a difference in the irrigated area of different states. Means if we talk about Mizoram, Mizoram has 7.3% area of total area sown under irrigation, while 90.8% is in Punjab. What we are trying to we need to understand here is that these are two different places, right? Mizoram and Punjab. Punjab is an area with 5 rivers, a rich river water. So 90.8% area sown is in Punjab, whereas only 7.3% area of the total area zone is from Mizoram. Okay, so there is a vast difference between the total area under irrigation with the total area zone. More than 40% area of the total area zone is under irrigation in Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Jammu Kashmir, Tamil Nadu and Manipur. Water crisis. Here we need to understand what is water crisis and what are the reasons behind water crisis. Water is a natural gift. The shortage of water is constantly intensified due to increasing demand of grains by increasing population, right? There is a crisis, water crisis. Why? Because of more population. Day by day the population is increasing, and with increase in population there is an increase in the demand of grains also. To grow cash crops, increasing urbanization and changing lifestyle of the people, these are the other reasons of leading to water crisis. The position of water supply and the inequality in the local distribution and challenges to human interests, livelihood and economic development. Nowadays, the water crisis is in very alarming stage in arid regions of western Rajasthan and the interior area of southern peninsular plateau. These are the two areas wherein we can see severe water crisis. The quality of water has deteriorated, right? The quality of water, it is getting low, down. That is called as deteriorated in many villages and in some towns also. Many waterborne diseases spread because of this deteriorated water. Availability of pure potable water is the basic need of life, right? Without potable water, our human life, it is a difficult situation for us to sustain. Apart from the attempts made to increase the facility of potable water, there is a large difference between the demand of water and its supply. Right, we are trying a lot to make the potable water available to the entire population, but still this demand of water is more against less supply. Even today there is a severe shortage of drinking water of in about 8% of towns in India. Still the work remains to provide clean drinking water to about 50% of villages of our country. Continuing with the water crisis, 2/3 of our agricultural region still depends on rainwater, and rainwater is uncertain. Groundwater has gone down considerably due to more and more water, because the more and more water is extracted through wells and tube wells, right? People keep on extracting the water, and against that, if there is less rainfall, the groundwater is going to get low. Serious problems like reduction in equality of water and increasing scarcity has to be faced. Water is used in industries in uncontrolled quantity. Main sources of pollution are pollution of water we are talking about are polluted water and that of domestic uses and industries. These are the polluted water, they pollute our main sources of water also, and thus the water gets quality of the water gets deteriorated. Management and conservation of water resources. Now we are going to see how to conserve our water resources. Okay, the maintenance of water resource is known as water conservation. What is the meaning of water conservation? That means when we try to maintain our water resources, that this thing is known as water conservation. More constructions of reservoirs for water storage, connecting two river basins and bringing the groundwater at a higher level. These are all the different ways through which we can maintain and manage the water. Water is a national resource. Next topic is watershed development. Watershed, it is a natural unit and it is used by synthesized development in smaller natural units according to convenience. Synthesized means made, bringing two things together. Okay, synthesized, bringing two different things together, something like that. A river basin, so actually in watershed development what happens, two rivers, river basins are being watershed development Watershed is a natural unit and it is used for synthesized development in smaller natural units according to the convenience. Now here synthesized means to form by combining two parts, two different things is referred to as synthesized development, means it is not a natural development but can be formed also. Okay, so watershed is this kind of, it is a synthesized development. A river basin is such an area wherein the water of a river along with the water of its branches forms a watershed. So what happens when a river basin is there in particular areas? Okay, the water of the river gets collected at one place or passes through a place, and wherein the other basins wherein the other branches of the river are also getting collected. Okay, so this place where this water gets collected from different different branches can be referred as watershed. So what is watershed? It is basically ultimately a river basin only. The water during the rainy season flows forward and finally meets any river. The development of a watershed is an overall approach of development, right? It includes programs like soil. Now what is the benefit of making a watershed or having a watershed development? When a watershed development is been practiced, it will help to solve many of the problems like soil and humidity conservation, water storage, tree plantation, forestation, horticulture, development of pastoral land will be possible, renewal of collective resources is there. So these are all the advantages of having a watershed. Now, in all these programs, the land capability and the requirements of the people have to be considered, right? What is the capacity of the land? Is there a possibility of making a watershed or not? That is one question. And the other thing is, we need the support of the local people. It needs the participation of local people. Many schemes, such kind of schemes have been planned by the state and central government. Rainwater harvesting. Special methods to collect the rain and conserve it, including the construction of wells, small dams, khet talaudis are the farm ponds. By doing this thing, we try to conserve or collect, store the rain water. This is called as rainwater harvesting. What are the objectives of rainwater harvesting? This may fulfill the requirements of domestic use and agriculture. Along with this, to increase rainwater harvesting is done with an intention to increase the capacity to conserve the groundwater and increase the groundwater table. Second, reduce the water pollution. More and more rainwater is being conserved, then it helps us in reducing the water from getting polluted. Improve the quality of groundwater to save the land roots from water logging. Okay, when the rainwater is being diverted towards a proper place where it can be stored, the pollution is also controlled, means the water will not get polluted also. Then because of heavy rain, where there is water logging in the streets in the cities, that can also be avoided because we have diverted the extra water and it is getting stored. Reduce the surface runoff of water. This is stopping the water from getting wasted, right? We can properly put certain pipelines on connecting our terrace to the water tank, through which the extra water which is just running down and getting polluted, that can be stopped. Okay, so that is reduce the surface runoff water. Fulfill the requirements of domestic water requirements during summer and during long spells, dry spells. During the time of summer, right, where there is shortage of water, this water can be utilized. Fulfill the increasing demand of water and to make arrangements to store rainwater in underground tanks in multi-storied residences in large cities, or arrangements should be made so that the water percolates in the grounds. These are all the ways through which we can save the rainwater and the objectives which will help us because of rainwater harvesting. Points for water management. use water economically for gardens, vehicles and wash basins. That means people have a habit of keeping the top tap on while they are brushing, right? And the water is flowing off. So this should not be there. This should be stopped. Public awareness should be created. People should be made aware regarding the saving of water. Next, if possible, recycle the used water, right? For example, the water of the kitchen water can be always recycled by watering it into the plants. So this way also we can recycle or reuse the water. Save the reservoirs from pollution. The used reservoir should, if they get polluted, then the whole of the water which has been stored in the reservoir gets useless. So this reservoir should not get polluted. Increase the use of water harvesting structures like wells, tube wells, khet talavadi, etc. More and more use of this kind of water harvesting structures, that is wells, tube wells, we should increase the number of harvesting structures. Keep a watch on the units those are using groundwater. Whichever units are using groundwater for different purposes, maybe irrigation and say any other thing, there should be a watch into that, onto that, and they should be stopped or prevented as and when anything wrong is found. Prevent the deterioration of water storage units and repair the damaged pipelines immediately to stop water pollution. Okay, whenever many a times we find that there is for some reason the pipelines get broken, and at that time we know so much of water is being wasted. So at an earliest we should call the people responsible and to see that the pipeline gets repaired, because if this polluted water mixes up with the other main pipelines, then that can spoil the other water also. So it is very much necessary to get it repaired at an earliest.